Good morning, friends. How are you? How was your weekend? Did you all enjoyed it? I hope you have revised our last part. So today we are going to study a new topic, that is circle division. Okay? Are you all ready? Okay. So friends, we had studied in the last part that a circle can be divided into 360 equal parts. So one part will be of 1 degree. So we had studied that. So now we are going to divide a circle into two equal parts. So I have divided here circle into two equal parts. So what will be the degree of one part? What will be the angle degree of one part? So a full circle is 360 degree. That you know. Okay? A full circle is 360 degree. So when we divide this circle into two equal parts, then 360 divided by 2, one part will be of 180 degree. Okay? One part will be of 180 degree. Now, a circle is divided into three equal parts. Okay? A full circle is of 360 degree and we have divided that into three equal parts. So 360 divided by 3, that will be 120 degree. So one part will be of 120 degree. Now I am going to divide the circle into four equal parts. So four equal parts. Now one full circle is of 360 degree. 360 divided by 4, that is 90 degree. So one part will be of 90 degree. Is it clear? Okay. So now we are going to divide the circle into 5 equal parts. Okay. We are going to divide the circle into 5 equal parts. So one part will be of 72 degree. How? One full circle is of 360 degree. Then 360 divided by 5, that is 72 degree. Okay. Now likewise, I have divided the circle into 8 equal parts. So one part will be of angle 360 by 8, that is 45 degree. So this is how we can get the angle of the circle. Okay. Friends, you can see in your box two instruments like this. These are set squares. One will be like this and one will be like this. In this set square, these two angles will be 45 degree and this angle will be 90 degree. Okay, in this set square, one angle will be 30 degree. That is, the small angle will be 30 degree and one angle will be 60 degree and the other angle will be 90 degree. Likewise, here I have drawn an angle. This is an angle. This square corner is 90 degree. This square corner is 90 degree. Such an angle is called right angle. Is it clear? Okay. So now friends, we are going to study how to draw angles of 72 degree at the center of the circle. It can be any degree. It can be 100, it can be 72, it can be 80, any degree. Okay. So now we are going to draw 72 degree at the center of the circle. First of all, I will be drawing a circle. So this is the circle. Now I will be drawing a line.
So this is a straight line, and we will put the protractor at the line, on the line, and I will mark 72 degrees. So now I have marked the 72 degrees. Now I will draw a straight line. Okay, and we will mark the 72 degrees. Now again I will mark 72 degrees from the new line. From the new line. So marking 72 degrees. And drawing a straight line. Now again marking 72 degrees from the new line. And drawing straight line. Now again marking 72 degrees using protractor. Drawing a straight line. And that will be 72 degrees. So when you measure the other part, you can get the angle will be 72. The angle will be 72. So I will mark the 72 angle here. Okay. So now we will join every lines. So now we got a pentagon. We got a pentagon. Okay. This is how we will draw angles of different degrees. Is it clear now? Okay.
So friends, you can see a circle here. I have divided the circle into two parts. One is the shaded part and the other is the non-shaded part. And the non-shaded part is of angle 20 degrees. So now, you want to tell me how much will be the shaded part. How much will be the shaded part? That answer should be in the form of fraction. That answer should be in the form of fraction. Okay? So now we know this is of angle 20 degrees. So out of 360 degrees, this part is of 20 degrees. So now 20 degrees divided by 360, you will be getting 1/80. That is, when we divide the circle into 18 equal parts, one part will be of 20 degrees angle measurement. One part will be of 20 degrees angle measurement. Otherwise, if you multiply 18 into 20, you will be getting 360. So there is 18 part in the circle. One part is of 20 degree. All the 18 parts will be of 20 degree. So now we got that 1/18. This part is 1/18. So the non-shaded part is 1/18. And the other part will be of shaded part. Other part will be shaded part. So the other part will be 17/18. Other part will be 17/18. Is it clear? I will show one more example. So friends, this is the another example. Here I have divided the circle into two parts. One is the shaded part and the other is the non-shaded part. Now the non-shaded part is of angle 80 degrees. Non-shaded part is of angle 80 degrees. And Here we want to find how much will be the shaded part. How much will be the shaded part? The same way, 80 divided by 360. One full circle is of 360. So this part is 80 degree. So 80 divided by 360 equal to 2/9. Equal to 2/9. That is, when we divide a circle into 9 equal parts, 2 parts will be of angle 80 degree. Okay? 2 parts will be of angle 80 degree. So, this is the non-shaded part that we got 2/9. So, non-shaded part is of 2/9. And the shaded part is the rest, that is 7/9. 7/9. Is it clear now? So, dear friends, this is for today. I will be giving activities for you. I hope you all understood the concept. And if you have any doubt, you can contact me. So, bye-bye.